lips of the righteous feed many, but fools die for lack of sense. Is what you say, is what we talk about, is how we relate and communicate to each other, is it feeding the soul of the hearer? Or is it causing malnutrition? Do you understand the premise of all this? The one thing that Christ has commanded that we do is what? Make disciples. In the sense of the context of being people of God. And yet so often we believe that that's a corporate issue. That's not a corporate issue. This isn't disciple making, although you can be discipled through preaching. This is preparation for disciple making. Maturing in Christ. Learning what it takes and why the gospel is the power of God to teach you how to eat and then feed others so that they may feed others, so that they may feed others. And I've said it and I'll say it until I die. If you aren't making a disciple, you are living in direct disobedience to the command of Christ. He did not say serve and do and this. He didn't say that. It's not wrong to do that. But He said to make disciples. Teach others. How do we teach others? That doesn't mean everybody's going to be a teacher. It doesn't mean everybody's going to be a Sunday school director. It doesn't mean everybody's going to be a pastor or an evangelist. But it does mean that in your life, as you sit at breakfast, or as you sit in your living room, or as you talk on the phone with your family, or as you're walking down the street, or as you're at Starbucks, or as you're at the coffee shop, or wherever you might be, you are to be thinking and praying for God to use your words and use your life so that the gospel may be clear. Because Christ is your highest treasure. And therefore, what your job is and what your goal is in life is that when you hear someone talk about how bad the economy is, that you talk about how awesome the cross is. Because it doesn't matter. You know, the greatest riches in the world is the fact that God has saved me from my grievous and wretched sinfulness. And on the back of His Son, He put my sin, and I am alive in Christ. The message needs to be there. The decision to be obedient needs to be there. And our words ought to be food. They ought to feed. The grace of God feeds the people of the world. It feeds the church. And what's crazy, if we just practiced this in the confines of the body of Christ, we'd be 500% more effective in our faith. We'd understand all good things that we have in our faith in Jesus Christ, as Philemon 6 says, because we're sharing our faith with each other. Sharing our faith, just like this coming Sunday, we have a meal together. That's not sharing our faith. Sharing our faith is as iron sharpens iron, so one man sharpens another. That happens through the words of our mouth, not the gentleness of our hand. And honestly, Proverbs 12:6 says, the words of the wicked lie in wait for blood, but the mouth of the upright delivers them. Freedom comes through grace. So every aspect of our lives ought to exude that grace. Grace of God is that He, with His own pleasure, in His own will, in His own way, in His own decision, has given grace to the lost people of the world that they might be called the righteousness of God because Christ has paid for their sin. And our words ought to reflect that. Because that's freedom. The Son sets you free, you are free indeed. You are free indeed.